Ozone therapy has a long history across the world, from the 1800s to present day. So where did it come from? Ozone has been used in medicine for over 100 years. Ozone was discovered in 1840 by a German-Swiss chemist named Christian Schoenbein. Studies of disinfection by ozone followed, and the first ozone generator was created by von Siemens in 1857. Marius Paul Otto, a French chemist, gained a doctorate for an essay he wrote on ozone. He created the first company to specialize in making ozone installations. In 1896, inventor Nikola Tesla patented the first ozone generator in the United States. As the 19th century ended, he started making and selling ozonated olive oil. In the midst of World War I, ozone therapy was used via limb bagging to fight gangrene and trench foot in soldiers, in an attempt to reduce amputations. By the 20s, it was widespread in Europe and parts of the United States. In the 1930s, a number of important events occurred. Swiss dentist Dr. E.A. Fish used ozone in his practice and published papers on the subject. In the mid-30s, physicians Aalborg and Lacoste started introducing ozone to the body via rectal and vaginal insufflations, as well as by injecting gas into wounds. No harmful side effects were reported after over 8,000 applications. In 1933, however, the American Medical Association set out to eliminate any medical treatments that could compete with pharmaceutical drug treatments. Despite this, in 1940, a German doctor named Hans Wolff wrote a book called Medical Ozone that is still used today. During World War II, a doctor named Robert Mayer learned how ozone was used for German POWs and incorporated it into his practice for decades. The study and practice of ozone therapy has only increased over time. In 1957, Dr. J. Hansler patented an ozone generator that served as the basis for the expansion of ozone in Germany. In 1961, Dr. Hans Wolff introduced major and minor autohemotherapy using ozone. In 1971, Wolff and Professor Siegfried Reiling founded the German Medical Society of Ozone Therapy. The early 1980s saw the creation of a German medical textbook called Medical Ozone, and the first international ozone medical conference in Washington, D.C. By the end of 1987, Reiling and Dr. Renat Vibon published The Use of Ozone in Medicine that remains a standard text on ozone therapy applications. In the early 1990s, Cuban doctors reported success with the treatment of diseases like glaucoma and conjunctivitis with ozone, and Russian doctors successfully used ozone in brine baths to treat burns. By the mid-90s, ozone therapy started to gain popularity in the United States again, as well as many other countries. While more studies helped get the word out to physicians about ozone's efficacy. Today, there is an influx of physicians interested in using ozone therapy to help treat a variety of conditions. As this interest grows, so has the interest of many mainstream consumers and patients. And this is going to propel even more study of the potential benefits of ozone therapy. If you like this video or would like more information on ozone, visit our videos page or our YouTube channel. Subscribe to our channel and click the notification bell to be informed when we upload new videos. For more information on PromoLife's ozone therapy generators, glassware, and accessories, visit www.promolife.com.